It's Nancy today, and how are you today? So it's 7 o'clock. I've heated up the living room. It's negative 17 outside. Oh, I was going to tell you what that was in Fahrenheit. Probably about 2 Fahrenheit. So, here is my thrummed mitten. There is my mitten. I'm using the inside, and I am creating this on it, which I will then felt, and it will shrink down a whole lot, be half the size, and it will keep my hand very warm. Now, thrumming is generally done on the inside, so you could try and turn this back. I'm going to show you how thick this is. See, you can't even dig down to the middle. That's going to keep my hand warm. I'm so tired of having cold hands when I go outside, so I'll be able to put them straight in here. So I'll show you how I do it now. Of course, I can't really... It's always so hard to have a proper surface. Good morning, good morning. You're here. It's nice to see you. Okay, so the way we thrum... Okay, so we've got this mitten. Okay, so... I'll start here where I haven't done it yet. Let's see. We'll go back here to the edges. But you know how you add it? You push this whole thing up, like so, all the way. And then you take your crochet hook, which happens to be under the camera, not the right place to put it. And then you need to take the long ones. I have not felted them because it's easier this way. They're all lined up already. You just open it up a little bit. Just pull off a small amount. That might be a little too small. So then, let's see if I can put it here where you can see what's going on. I don't think there's going to be any way to show this to you without getting a tripod, which I don't have. I have them. They're not set up for this. Okay, see if I can do it like this. Okay, so right here we have a place, right? We push this away, and then we come into an area close by. See how thin my yarn is? Wasn't such a brilliant move for a warm mitten. So then this is the new piece, you see? And we just lay it up against the rest. Okay, let's go back here and we'll try and do the side of the thumb. Now the thumb I don't want to cover as thickly because if I turn it inside out, which I just may do, which I don't know if I'm going to do yet or not. Now this is in the grease, which means that has not been washed. Which I think is a good thing because I think the oils will keep my So we're not putting these as close. Instead of putting it down here, I'm going to put it up here a little bit. Take somewhere near the end of it. Pull it through. Okay, even it up, put them together, and lay them forward. When they felt, they won't be moving anywhere at all. They'll be stuck there forever. Oh, good morning. We have 4 people and 0 likes. Not time yet, is it? Well, that's okay. All Our daughters' daughters will adore us, and they'll sing in grateful chorus. Well done. I did this last night while we were watching TV, only I got no TV watched. Look at how pretty my fingernails are. They're nice, they just grow. Alright, so now I'm gonna come to the back of it. Or we can work on the side. How can I show you? I think I have to work backwards if I show you. Don't look, we'll start down here at the... Oh wait, we're still working on the thumb. So this is just raw fleece. You can go to a farmer who farms sheep and ask if they're going to shear their sheep and if you can have any wool, or if you can buy the wool. You can go to Wool Growers Cooperative. I think there's one in Carleton Place, Ontario. And you can... It's about 15 minutes outside of Ottawa. Too bad you can't see what I can see. That was that good old GoPro thing. So, it's Saturday morning. I want to go for a walk so badly, but it's been cold, like raw kind of cold. Oh, I hear there's going to be a storm somewhere in North Carolina in the mountains. Have they named the storm? I kind of like it when they name the storms. Then I can remember which time it was. Like Michael, I can remember now. You know, Michael is when Panama City got wiped out. How many places have been wiped out lately? Like, New Orleans got wiped out and they brought it back. And now Paradise, Hawaii got wiped out and Paradise, California. Lay up your treasures in heaven, eh, where paradise will not cease to exist, where it cannot be destroyed. It's pretty rough. I don't get too many videos. You know, I know there must be hundreds of people posting small videos about this situation. I go to YouTube and, you know, you only get the really... new ones, I guess, if you, and then not only the new ones, but the big ones. Did I tell you I found my binoculars? So you see, this has a bit of a dent there, right? So that means that I need to put one here. So I'm not putting as many right between them because it's going to be laying against the other one. But I'll put some because, you know, it's got to be warmer than this. To talk to you last night. I wanted to say goodnight before I went to bed, but I thought all these posts coming into 14,000 people's homes that say, Nancy, today is live. I don't want to bother everybody so they unsubscribe. That's what happens if you post too many videos. People start to unsubscribe because it's too many things in their mailbox on the same day. wonder if we can do it so that we can both see it. Let's see what we can do here. So I'm going to do this to all my homespun mittens. Because, except the felted one. The felted one is great. You know, this is kind of like rug hooking for a rug on the floor. Those latch kit hook things, you don't have to buy all those yarns. You could just use wool. If you make a rug out of wool, it will fall apart. I mean, all the dirt will fall right through it. I should have waited until I had more spent yarn made, like I spun it. I should have waited until it was more of all the same width. Good morning. How's life this morning over there? Thanks for thumbing up. If you want to know when these videos show up, you have to click that notification thing. Anyway, so this is just a video for conversation between us, of course. So I'm waiting for you to say something. So it got really cold last night. Negative 17 is pretty darn cold. That's the January kind of weather. Sometimes our coldest weather is right around Christmas time. Which makes sense, the solstice. It's the shortest days ever. So it's 7 o'clock-ish here. It was 7 o'clock. So now it's after 7, I guess. Desmond got in bed with me this morning. Must have been quite early. Because I went back to sleep. And he just laid there underneath the blankets. Oh, when I went to bed, the light came on outside. The light was already on, and so I had to walk past the deer near the window. Like, it's really kind of a scary thing for them because I put their food, like, a meter from the door. Sometimes put it right against the door. And so I can lay there and have a great look, but it doesn't, they don't seem to get to trust me so much. I guess they trust me because they don't run away. But they don't like eat out of my hand or anything. So this, I have Google Earth now, which I think is really fun. I mean, not Google Earth, Google Home. And I have subscribed to Google Music. So yesterday I was listening to Mary Poppins. I think I'm gonna listen to all those musicals. Those musicals said something important. They were good. See, I finished my piece that I was working with. So, you can see this. Now, I know it's dirty. Don't let that bother you. Okay, so this is all going to be... come. So, how many will this come to be? One. The nature will fall out as you work with it. And then, of course, when you wash it. So you can pull them apart ahead of time, but you're most likely to get them all tangled up again. So I would suggest just pulling the next one off as you need it. Now these bits here, see this? This is way too short. None of these fibers are long enough. This is why when you card, you remove all that stuff. So I'm telling you how not to do it so that I can show you how to do it that way. Strange, eh? Says one thing and does another. Imagine such a thing. Oh, I heard somebody. I think it might be Desmond. He didn't go to school again yesterday. He lay around, kind of sleeping and laying around. Amaya's sick too. They were both throwing up all night the night before that. Friday night, Thursday night. Mommy took the day off and stayed with them. I appreciated that because, I mean, I'm a nice person, but taking care of a child that's throwing up on all the clothes and the blankets and everything, those were the hardest days of my life. Well, maybe they weren't the hardest. They were the worst. But they were really gross. And you could never catch up because you never had enough room for all those blankets and sheets. I mean, that was the main reason that I owned tons of blankets and sheets, was because you never knew when you were going to need them. And if you needed them and you didn't have them, that would be pretty rough, right? Good morning. Are you doing stuff? Do you just have me on in the background? I understand that. I wouldn't want to sit and watch somebody all day. That's a lot of trouble to sit down and watch somebody. The only reason I'm doing all these things like thrumming is because I'm sitting around. I don't usually sit around very much. But when I do, I like it. I like to be busy when I'm sitting around. I'll show you this thumb. It's coming along. So did you get to see the food video I made last night? Made the three of them. First I prepped all the vegetables. Everything for this thing. I can't believe I made that. That was really hard. Like, it took a lot of time and a lot of effort, a lot of preparing all those foods. I think that cooked garlic, baked garlic, is really the way to use garlic. I don't think we should have it raw or sautéed. I think that the baking, the slow cooking, I don't know. But I think that's... tastes a lot better. It doesn't have a sharpness. Now I have to look it up. Does baked garlic have the same properties as cooked garlic? Raw garlic, I mean. And everything raw is more potent, right? You can't eat a raw garlic. You can, but you may die. You may just die. Die of bad taste in your mouth. Our daughters, daughters will adore us and will sing. Mary Poppins is quite the show. Just listening to the soundtrack, the first thing is the wife singing about women's rights and equality. And then the second song is the man coming home and how everything is as it should be, which means that all these things are provided for him at exactly this time. At 6 o'clock, he walks through the door. At 6:01, his sherry and pipe are due. At 6:02,
Ah, lordly is the life I lead. Well, I guess those suffragettes really changed that, eh? I like being a mom at home. I don't think that there's a career out there that would have given me the fulfillment that I've gotten at home. Plus, having a career would have meant getting up early and rushing off every single day of my life. And I don't like the idea of that. I like the idea of doing exactly what I want. And luckily, I have the most amazing husband who likes it that I'd like to be at home. It's really hard to stay at home if your husband thinks you should be earning money. But my time spent out in the woods and everywhere else is a blessing to my family because I become a lot nicer person. And I'm more interesting. I have things to talk about. All these animal tracks I'm seeing. Man, I gotta get over there again, but it's negative 17. And the thing is that once you're over there, you're a long way away. And I have no shelter over there. I have no place that I can go and heat it up. I could have a campfire, but you know, you don't have a campfire and run risks. And anyway, a campfire doesn't heat you up as well as a house does. Right? A campfire will heat you up on one side. But you know, I've always said that if you go to bed and your blanket's not warm enough, just throw a sheet over the top of your covers. Don't throw on another blanket. Just throw on a sheet. And it effectively blocks in all the heat leaving your body and traps it there under the sheet in that nice blanket. And so then you get very warm. It's a perfect way. And so if you dress and you toss a blanket over the top, I'm not much on sweaters because sweaters, they're kind of bulky, and I think sweaters are better now because I'm not so big. I can do a sweater without, you know, getting all bunched up too much. Do you like watching this? It's too early to talk, eh? Nobody said anything. But I'm lonely. I'm the only one up in the house. Oh, God is up. Hi, God. He's really my good friend. My gosh, he does so much for me. I'm always getting blessings. I have lots of challenges too, mind you. But I have so many blessings that happen all the time. And challenges are not a big deal. They're not a big problem. Except that they bring out the worst in us. And then, of course, we can see what the worst in us is and we can fix it. We can do something about it to become a nicer person. That when you get to be an old grandma or old grandpa, you're a nicer person, you're patient because you've lived through things, you've learned that bad things come and bad things go. And the only way you learn that is because it's happened to you over many, many years. If you look back, you can probably look on every year and find difficulties that are just for that time. Of course, sometimes we give ourselves difficulties by not being careful enough who we marry. Really need to be careful. You need to ask all those questions. And if you've had bad choices for boyfriends in your life, you might want to go to therapy. Because I figured when I got out of a bad marriage that there must have been something wrong with me if I thought that was going to be a good marriage. Why did I choose this kind of person? There's a good book called Women Who Love Too Much, which is sort of how people end up being the abused wife. You think they can solve everything. I'll fix this. He'll be nicer because I'll love him so much and he'll be so nice to me or he'll change because I'm able to do this, which will make him change. That is the fallacy upon which Alcoholics Anonymous and Al-Anon and everything else, all those groups, those are based on. It's the lack of realizing that there's a difference between what you can change and what you can't change. How does that go? God grant me the serenity to accept the things I cannot change, the courage to change the things I can. See, I'm coming around the edge of the thumb there. And the wisdom to know the difference. So let's talk about that then. What can you change? Can you change your husband? Beep. Nope. Your husband is your husband. He will be that way his whole life. And I'm sorry to disappoint you, but just like you have faults, and it'll take you your lifetime to get over them, so with your husband. Now, the reason that this is a big deal is because you choose those faults that you want to live with. So, believe it or not, sometimes it's better to be alone than to be in a bad relationship. And all you have to do is ask anybody, say, is it better to be alone than to be in a bad relationship? But see, we don't always recognize that our relationship is a bad relationship because we are loved. And once you know that you are loved, and if you haven't had a chance to be loved very often or ever, then if somebody loves us, we figure it's going to be fine. Whatever it will be, we can handle this. But sometimes we can't, because sometimes some people are not mature enough to realize not to blame other things. I blame things a lot. The reason my house is a mess. Other person's fault. Whereas really, I can see my mess. And I can know that if not for that person making their mess there, I am making a mess anyway somewhere else. So easy to think that we're right. Did you know, I used to tell my children when they were little that the jails are full of people that had a good reason for what they do. I remember my kids would fight and they would say, he hit me for no good reason. And which often made me think, well, does that mean that there is a good reason to hit somebody? Is there a good reason for children to hit children? Is there a good reason for people, for husbands to hit wives or wives to hit husbands? No. There's justification by our own rationality, right? Rationalizing. We can rationalize anything away. I am the best rationalizer. You know, if you're smart, you can come up with lots of reasons. And, oh, I hear movement. The whole house vibrated a bit. Somebody got up on heavy feet. Must be a dash to the bathroom. Stumble out of bed. First stop. Then deal with life. Desmond comes in my room and gets me out of bed and says, he hands me my glasses and then he hands me my teeth and he hands me my hearing aid. He tells me I'm old. And I'm going to die because I'm so old. I am 63. Which I thought, once you hit 60, your life is like, you can't be considered a real person anymore for 60. No, because you now live in a totally different world. You live in a world of aches and pains and doctor's appointments and retirement, travel, grandchildren. Of course, you know what? Wouldn't that be nice if I was had to work and I was still working? I'm only 63. Do you realize I would still be going to work? A friend of mine was looking so far forward to her life after retirement. And she retired. And then her husband got sick. Well, he was already. He had diabetes. Diabetes is no joke. It makes your toes, makes your legs, you know, you lose your feet. You lose your toes or your. down to 166.8 this morning. Oh, good morning, Asheville Moving Company. I haven't talked to you for a long time. I love your videos. Now, where do they go? The way you were holding it earlier, I thought you had a Santa beard. You can't imagine how much you inspire me. Thanks for doing your videos so often. Hope you visit with me if you're ever back in North Carolina. I know, I saw you back there. I mean, when I used to come to Asheville. Well, no, you would talk to me when I was going to Anderson. I did go to Asheville once. Did you ever see those videos from Asheville? They were, I went to got my teeth pulled out there because we don't have dental coverage as part of our government health care. I have a word to say about government health care. People say, oh no, that's terrible, that's socialized. Well, you know, the only thing that's bad about health care from the government is that is there a reason it's bad? Anyway, people say socialized. Do you have, what do your taxes pay for? Okay, do your taxes pay for things that are a handout? Like your road getting plowed? And the fire department coming? And your school for your children? Or for yourself? And you say you don't like socialized things? You think it's a socialist society if the government provides things? Would you like it if the government did not provide and pay for your fire department service? Would you like to fund that yourself? Or depend on the goodness of all your neighbors? Or we'd all have to have our own trucks? So, oh, I know, the only people that suffer with government-funded health care, see, you still pay. You just pay it in a different direction, and you pay one price, not a price that goes up and down according to how sick you are. And it's not an unaffordable price, it's just part of your taxes. Many people that don't have jobs that are like working in a desk, if you sell stuff to people, like you make firewood, for instance. Yes, I discovered you and you posted a video here shopping on your way to Georgia. I have been following you ever since. Really? Grateful? How has this changed your life? Is it just that it's fun to see this person that does all these different things? So glad I have my mojo back. I completely lost my mojo for a while there when my mom died and when I was going back and forth to Georgia. I had no time for creativity. I was so busy. Well, I was creative down there. I was always trying to find things that I could improve in my mom's life. So I got her new hearing aids. It was all her money, right? It's not like I did it, but I took her and I made the appointments. She had cataract surgery. She had new ears. She had no mobile devices, or not mobile devices. She had no mobility devices, like a walker. She had a cane that was straight on the end. So we got canes that had 4 feet. Suddenly she could walk places without being so afraid she was going to fall. So then she started going up to the mailbox every day, where I put a swing for her, a porch swing, because it was quite a little hike up to the mailbox. And if she had a porch swing, she could sit there and relax, watch the traffic, talk to the people. There's a lot of people that would walk down the road having their exercises. Christine McClure Sabine. Hi, Christine. I've been watching your videos for years. So cool that you're doing this live and I'm having coffee with you this morning. Yes, isn't that great? That's the best. I don't think I'm going to just go back to regular videos anymore. Except, oh wait, you said something else there. Oh no, that was Asheville and now Christine. Christine McClure. Mr. McClure, in Georgia. He was the band leader. My children, my brother and sister were in band. My brother played the trombone. Oh, I hear baby Maya. It's daddy's day to sleep in, so it's probably mommy coming down with him. Maya's two, and she does not like grandma when mommy's around. When mommy's not there, oh, she loves grandma. Tummy hurts too. Here's a blanket you can put on in front of the heater. Desmond's got all of his things here he's been playing with. See, he was making something with this?
Yeah.
He was putting them all together, making a picture. And these are socks in case anybody's feet are cold. Are your feet cold?
No.
Okay, you need to sit on this right beside Desmond. You can put this close. Oh, you're going upstairs?
You.
You can stay here. Oh, you mean Maya. Desmond, Maya Desmond wants you to play with him. Maya. Maya Paya. I'm getting hot.
She really doesn't listen to me.
Excuse me? She doesn't listen to you?
Yeah.
Do you know anybody else like that?
No.
This looks like a totem pole. You know when you have that up like that? It reminds me of like a statue of a raven. I like this outfit. This is a dress. Looks better when I've got it all figured out properly. Anyway, there's a dress, and then this other one, and they're the same color. And this other one is too thin to wear in the winter. But with this on it, which is also too thin, it makes it thick enough. We're clearly soldiers in petticoats. Oh, you know what? If you're ever outside and you're cold and you have a blanket on like this, I suggest if you have any blanket in your house, and I would say if it's about 8 feet square, that would be the best. And then you cut a hole, but not right in the center of the top, because the back of you goes around, like it's longer to get to the bottom, going the back than the front. He didn't want her to leave. What are you going to eat now, Maya? We're clearly soldiers in petticoats. The hair has got to be trimmed because the ends are so ragged. That means I have to go to the hairdresser because every time I cut it myself. Is something rotten? Mommy said it was rotten. Mommy said that it was rotten. The peanut butter that's in the jar, in the little container. All righty. Should know that? Did you already know that?
Yeah.
What happened? Did you get hurt? Are you going to go get mommy to get a kiss? Is Desmond going to bring mommy down, or are you going to go right up and get in bed with mommy? Okay, bye. I would rush right over there and take care of her, you know, but she doesn't want me to. So then it ends up with a big yelling, screaming thing. No, mommy! So I'm well trained. You're not getting very good lighting there, are you? I guess I could turn on the light. We're surely soldiers in petticoats. So, did you like this idea of thrumming? Our daughters' daughters will adore us, and they'll sing in graves. And I have a hole here. See how the hole right there? So that's a good place to put one. In fact, you can put it. I'm going to put a big one there because it's got a lot of room. And this will fill it up. Hello, who's back? Is that Mr. Desmond? Hi. Good morning. Are you warm enough?
Yeah.
I'm always concerned that you're warm enough. Oh, somebody said something. What does it say? You know, this is really cool. Everybody that's here today are new people that haven't been here on another day. I mean, come all the time to PC today.
Things?
Not on here. There's no way to type.
But I want to type.
See, we could make a comp, but see, there's nowhere to type it. Are you sure you're warm enough?
I don't know.
Here, how about putting a little fleece on your feet? No. Do you want to talk? You want to hold it and say something?
No.
If you look in there, your eyes will be looking. You'll see your eyes if you look that way. Oh, look what you found. What's in my cat? What is that? It's something green and something purple. What could it be? Is it purple grapes? Is it blueberries? And the green, is it lettuce?
No.
Is it peas?
No.
Is it?
It's a squeezy.
A squeezy? What is a squeezy?
A squeezy is a thing with squeeze with yummy stuff in it.
Do you have a yummy stuff you squeeze? Can you show the picture here? Can you put your squeezy so we can see it there? Goodbye.
And the blue and purple and the blue and brown thing.
What was that?
Nutri-Grain bar.
Nutri-Grain. Are those suitable for breakfast?
Yeah.
You're allowed to get them for breakfast every day? Yes. Excellent. Hey, look, I have a hat. I could be the real Nancy today. Hello, it's Nancy today. These hats are kind of big. I'm going to make more hats, but they're going to have to be smaller because...
Too big.
Too big. Did you want to wear this hat?
No.
No? Are you sure?
No, it won't fit me, and then you can't see.
Political equality and equal rights with men. Oh, Desmond's got something to do. Goodbye. Hey, I touched this, and now I can make all these things change. Normal. Beam. Bluish. Pop. Pop. How's pop different from regular? Regular, pop. Regular, pop. It gives a little more warmth, doesn't it? Crush, ugh. Glow.
What's that? Slate. Noir. Well, hello. We're having a black and white morning here. It's colorless day. Dream. Oh, now what's the difference in dream? Dream is really showing up my lumpy skin. Why does it matter? Like, who cares? If you don't look in the mirror, you don't have to know. But the thing is, if you go out... Hey, this one was something. This is pop. I like pop. Okay, let's keep pop. What do you think? You like those colors? I don't know how you know all those things. Hi, Nancy. How are you? I'm from Istanbul, Turkey. Is that right? What does it say? Suheyfa? Suheyfa? And then what's his last name? Icke. Icky. I know that's wrong. I don't know what's right. But I think you might tell me. Oh, here it is. Hi, Nan. So, in Istanbul, Turkey. I only hear about Turkey on the news. I don't know what it's like there. I know that when I went to Cyprus, right, so let's get right into the most contentious part of the whole thing, eh? When I went to Cyprus, the north part was off limits because Turkey had possessed it. And so the Cypriots, did not like Turks because they were taking over their part of the country. Whereas I never got to hear Turkey's side of it, which was probably something more like, we're having trouble with people from Cyprus bothering us, so we're going to go and put a stop to it. That's sort of the way things happen, isn't it? But now you've got a lot of things happening in Turkey. Now, are you allowed to talk online about the government and things you like and not like? I mean, I'm sure you see everything. Oh, are you in Istanbul, Turkey, or are you just from there? Istanbul was once Constantinople. I never knew that until that song. It's wonderful what you learn when you get involved in the world. Hey, the family's awake. I could put music on. What kind of music you want today? Christmas hymns. How about Oh Holy Night? Okay, Google. Play O Holy Night by the Mormon Tabernacle Choir. Okay, Google, increase volume to 30%. The traditional music. Why do we have to hear all these new people's rendition of these amazing songs? They're never as good after they jazz them up a bit. This is such a holy song. Okay, let's try another one. Okay, Google. Play O Holy Night. Now I can go on my. Did I stop being live? It said live. Long may the world in sin and error bind me till he appears and the soul found its worth. A thrill. So Nat King Cole changed it too. Fall on your knees. Oh, hear angel voice. Divine, oh night, when
Christ was born.
I miss the Christmas devotional. It was last Sunday night. It'll be online on lds.org. There's some amazing videos on there about Christ. Beautiful videos about the Savior's birth and his life and his ministry. Share the light. Share the light with other people. Here's your voices. Oh, night divine. Oh, night. Okay, so who else sings this? Who's the original singer of these? How about Christmas carols from the 50s? Oh, who used to go and... Bob Hope used to go and see the troops at Christmas. There was somebody else that did too. Anne Murray. Anne Murray sings good. Let's see what she sings. By Anne Murray. Well, okay, Google, play O Holy Night by Anne Murray. Play O Holy Night by Anne Murray.
O Holy Night by Anne Murray, sure. Playing on Google Play Music.
I don't like it when they change the pauses.
Stars are brightly shining. It is the night of the dear Savior's birth. Long lay the world in sin and error.
You know, the more comments that you make on here, the more of these videos will show up on everybody's feed, or on, you know.
A thrill of hope, the weary world rejoices, for yonder springs a new and glorious dawn.
Little curls.
Oh, night when Christ was born. Oh, night divine. Oh, night. Oh, night divine.
Okay, Google. Oh, I can change it in. Hi, Nancy. What are you making? I'm thrumming my mittens. See, here's my mitten. And I am going in each of these areas. And I hook on some straightened out. Please.
Oh, the angel.
So it will make them, is it will, it's huge, it's enormous. Anyway, what happens, it will, they'll shrink, right? They'll shrink around my hand, and there's no air coming in. They're very loose inside here. So this is Dean Martin. He sings the traditional stuff. My mother used to like traditional better than anything new. Christmas time. Except she used to like the arrhythmics, who were not old at the time.
Soon it will be Christmas Day. City sidewalks. Oops.
Now, this is not Christmas music. We can't allow this. So let's change it. Okay, Google. Play Christmas music by Lawrence Welk. Oh, we have to go.
Okay, playing Lawrence Welk on Google Play Music.
I used to think he was a real old fogey. My parents used to have a record player and they would put on Christmas albums. Hey, we could sing along with the Messiah. Do you want to do that? You're just getting into this music and then I change it. Doesn't sound like Christmas. How about that one? Oh, Sleigh Bells. Let's sing that one. That's one where they have that whip that snaps high above the horses. Uh-oh, crying upstairs. Okay, Google. Play Tom. What was that guy's name? Tom.
Sorry, I don't understand.
Play, okay Google, play a Christmas special with Anne Murray. See if we get anything.
Sorry, I don't know how to help with that yet, but I'm trying to learn.
Okay Google, play Christmas music. Oh wait, let's...
Sure, here's a Google Play Music station called Classic Christmas Hits.
So, you know, you guys get me wanting to do stuff. Usually I just want to walk. But now I want to visit with you guys. I want to see who's there and talk. And so I'm spending time sitting around doing this. A merry little Christmas. This is not one of my favorites. Learn how to cope with problems. That's the big deal about life. Learning to cope with problems. Be nice anyway? That's really hard. Next year, all our troubles will be See, we shouldn't really think about things will be better when, because they won't, because we take ourselves along with all of our weaknesses. And so if you don't like it the way it is now, if you see that there's problems with where you live, there'll be problems in the new place. Like there was a story told. Okay, Google. Reduce volume to 40%. I don't like this song. So hard to get good help. So now what should we tell OK Google? What do we want her to play? Can you just give me a hint there and then I can have it on there? OK Google, stop. Sleigh bells ring. OK Google. Play Sleigh Bells Ring.
Winter Wonderland, Sleigh Ride by Dolly Parton. Sure. That's playing on Google Play Music.
By Dolly Parton. Hope she didn't change it. Walking in the winter wonderland. You know, I called Willem yesterday. He couldn't hear me. And I called him again. He couldn't hear me. And he wasn't very far away. And he couldn't hear me. And so, and then he said, well, I answered you. Did you hear me?
No.
So who's got the problem? Say no, man. So let's see what Google Play Music can do with. Good morning, four people. So we've got Asheville Moving Company, and we have somebody in Turkey. And we have Helen in Scotland. All right, you're in Scotland, Helen. It's really hard on the parents when the children are sick. They're up all throughout the night. My parents work all day and can't sleep at night. Hard, eh? But, and it came to pass, it never came to stay. Every day is a little bit closer to the time that it won't be happening anymore. I wonder if it can play Oh, If I Were an Angel. Okay, Google. Play Oh, If I Were an Angel.
Oh, If I Were an Angel by Kathy Jones. Sure. Playing on Google Play Music.
Okay, Google. Increase volume by 10%. Think that's Christmas music. Okay, Google. Play Christmas carols.
All right. Here's a Google Play Music station called Solo Piano Christmas.
I wanted to sing with it.
can't play with this. Sing with a piano solo. See, it's getting light out. It's time to go and play. But I'm playing with you. So what's happening in your life right now, this morning? What's your plans for today? What's the best thing that happened to you yesterday? Best thing about your day. It's really cute how I'm listening to Maya. She's just learning to talk. So Abraham wants to come over today. So we have a Christmas thing at church. The men are going to feed the women. We're going to serve the women. And so... Or no, maybe the women are going to serve the family, everybody. Maybe the Relief Society is putting it on. And after that, we're going to go pick up Abe and bring him home. So he may be in my videos tomorrow. Well, tomorrow's Sunday and I'll go to church. As long as it's not freezing rain again or all those things that keep us from getting there. This mitten really looks like one of those mittens you dust with or polish your car. Just tired of having cold hands all the time. My biggest problem when I'm out there is that I've taken my hand out of my mitten for something, or I've used my mitten to push something or catch myself or something, and so my mitten has snow on it. And then sure enough, it gets wet. And this is wool, so it should be staying warm. But they're not staying warm. Good morning. 7 people here. 4 likes up. 4 thumbs up. Did you come because you saw the notification? Where did you come across this? Were you just online wandering around and this popped up? Because I hear that most of the people that come to my channel just sort of stumble upon it. There's not a lot of rhyme or reason anymore. Somebody said I've been on here since the beginning. That's not true. But nearly the beginning. I heard on the news one day that YouTube, which I never heard of, which I thought was Y, which was U-T-U-B-E, U-T-U-B-E. And they were talking about it on CBC Radio, and then they talked, it was because it had just been bought by Google, which was a big deal. Somebody made their fortune. And so they interviewed these two guys who were making a video, a vlog. They're making a video to each other every day for a year. And so, doesn't that look like the sun right there? What is that? It's on the... It's a light. Ah, yes. Feel free to speak up. She calls Desmond. See, so I go in here. I'll show you again what I'm doing. So I go into the area somewhere. Go under some string, just one. Grab this. Just pull one side of it. Pull it through. And don't bother knotting it because it's going to felt. Then you pull it in and make it kind of even. Then you push it out of the way.
Now, some people thrum as they knit. But, you know, I think that would take a lot of trouble. I think it's easier to do this later because you can do it fast and you don't have to confuse getting the wool with knitting. Just focus on one thing at a time. The delightful screams of children. I'm so blessed to have them here. Oh, my ears just went not deaf. Hey, I think my cough went away. I have mullein, which is very good for your lungs. It's a good expectorant. And so my throat is better, I think. All right, let's put this on. Click. I should take a screen picture. I didn't want to put too much in between here and there. Oh, that's nice and warm, though. Wow. My hand is going to be so happy. I'm going to make it really big on the end, too, so it fluffs down here so it's longer. Okay, Google. Play Peter and the Wolf. Yes. I had this album when I was little. Okay, Google, increased volume to 50%. Okay, Google, increased volume to 50%. Are you familiar with Peter and the Wolf? The song is sort of all the animals that talk have a certain musical note, a certain musical tune. And so this tune, see, hear that? Brahms? Good morning.
Good morning.
Did they sleep in the night?
Like this.
It's been years since I heard this.
Is the doctor played by the oboe?
You know, if you have Google Play Music on your, that was the duck, eh? You can download any, $9 a month, you download as many things as you want. It probably all goes away once you stop subscribing. But you can play all the songs that you like, that you never hear. Like, you never hear this, right? That was Sasha the cat.
Bassoon will represent grandfather.
Grandfather. I wonder if it's still negative 17 out there.
Peter opened the gate and went out into the big green meadow. Of a big tree sat a little bird, Peter's friend. All is quiet," chirped the bird gaily.
We're listening to Peter and the Wolf. It is narrated by David Bowie, of all people. And I'm thrumming a sock. I'm putting fleece all over it so it'll be nice and warm, and then I'm going to shrink it so it'll fit. It's going to be quite amazing.
Just then, a duck came waddling round. She was glad that Peter hadn't closed the gate and decided to take a nice swim in the deep pond in the meadow. Seeing the duck, the little bird flew down upon the grass, settled next to her.
My back feels much better today.
What kind of bird are you if you can't fly? Said he.
To this the duck replied, what kind of bird are you if you can't swim? And dived into the pond.
Oh, hi, we have somebody here. 9 people. Hi, Kiara. Hi, what's up? That's good. So, oh, look. You played it years ago, did you? Hi, Kristen from the Netherlands. It is wonderful when the little ones are learning to talk. It's really fun talking to them and listening to them. Yes, I do sound much better. I'm much better. I didn't know you guys had been talking over here. Hey, Blairzy Bell, you made it. You did it. You found me. We're together again. Making my mitten. Remember this? I felt my homespun mitten. I'm covering it with fleece. Now I'm going to shrink it. It's really nice though right now. It's really warm. I'll never have cold fingers again. But it needs to be long enough at the back.
Stealthily, she crept towards him on her velvet paws.
Sorry, I'm interrupting the music. I would never be sitting here if it weren't for you. Yesterday I wanted to go for a walk outside. It was so beautiful.
Look out! Shouted Peter. And the bird immediately flew up into the tree. While the duck quacked angrily at the cat. From the middle of the pond.
Sherpa. I don't know anything about Sherpa that the kids are wearing. Oh, Sherpa, isn't that the guide that's on the in the Himalayas or
the cat
Nepal?
Around the tree and thought, is it worth climbing up so high?
Look, there's my
thumb. By
the time
I get there, the bird will have flown away.
So I'll tell you, anybody that's just shown up. Hi, Kiara. Okay, so
just then,
you go close to what you've just done.
He was angry because Peter
you go in and out.
It's a dangerous place. If a wolf should come out of the forest, then what would you do?
And you put this in through. Even him up and lay him down. They won't go anywhere. They're going to be too tight. You can't even feel to the center of it. You can't even find the mitten through it anymore. I can't wait to eat that food I made yesterday. It was so good. Made that Thai yellow curry paste. It's so cool because it's an awesome taste. Your Krakofiev did such a lovely job with this piece. But Willem plays Prokofiev.
And led him home.
Last night it was so starry last night.
No sooner had Peter gone than a big gray wolf came out of the forest.
You said something. Thanks. Hi, Uma, you're back. This is great, eh? Being able to share our winter together a little bit. I know, you come and go. You guys have things to do. Me, no, nothing. I'm thrumming this. This is going to make my mitten very warm. So I'm putting a chunk of fleece through each area. So they makes good coverage. Not in every stitch, that'd be way too many.
In a twinkling, the cat climbed up into the tree. In her excitement, jumped out of the pond.
She should have stayed in the pond where she was safe.
But no matter how hard the duck tried to run, she couldn't escape the wolf. He was getting nearer. Nearer. Catching up with her. Then he got her, and with one gulp, swallowed.
Oh, there was a hawk on my deck yesterday. I think it was a falcon. Have to look him up in the bird book. But he was there. I think he might have come to eat the birds. Yeah, great, eh? The birds. There were a few birds. I think he was chasing a bird when they got here. The other bird disappeared. I look at this mitten, I think, oh my gosh, this is going to take forever. Then I think about doing a second one so they match.
Now,
impossible.
This is how things stood. A cat was sitting on one branch.
I'm debating on keeping or returning a kitten I got yesterday. I'm so stressed by it. I barely slept last night. I wish I was as chilled out as you're looking this morning. I would not keep a cat. Personally, if it stresses you out, I don't know. I'm not... I like animals that take care of themselves. Like, I don't mind feeding them outside, but I really don't want to have to clean my house up after animal... fur and everything. I'm a bit allergic to all that. I mean, I can be there, but it's not good for me.
And the wolf walked round and round the tree, looking at them with greedy eyes.
Oh, he loved it. It's interesting, Kira says you should keep the cat, and I say, if it gives you a lot of trouble, get rid of it. Cats are... Well, you know how it is. Some people think cats are the be-all and end-all, and some people think dogs are. Dogs give love. Cats take it. La, la, la. Maybe some cats give back, but usually if they do give back, they're quite demanding. Just, you know, what I've known from over the ages.
In the meantime, Peter, without the slightest fear, stood behind the closed gate watching all that was going on. He ran home, got a strong rope, and climbed up the high stone wall.
I wonder how old he is.
One of the branches of the tree around which the wolf was walking stretched out over the wall. Grabbing hold of the branch, Peter lightly climbed over onto the tree. Peter said to the bird, "Fly down and circle round the wolf's head. Only take care that he doesn't catch you." The bird almost touched the wolf's head with his wings, but the wolf smacked angrily at him from this side and that. Teased the wolf. How that wolf wanted to catch him. But the bird was clever, and the wolf simply couldn't do anything about it. Meanwhile, Peter made a lasso, carefully letting it down. Caught the wolf by the tail and pulled with all his might. Feeling himself caught, the wolf began to jump wildly, trying to get loose.
This is not very calm music, is it? Okay, Google. Okay, Google. Decrease volume by 20%.
Tied the other end of the rope to the tree. And the wolf's jumping only made the rope round his tail tighter.
Coming in, it's closing in. Have I been on here for 95 minutes? Well, waiting for it to warm up enough outside that I can go for a walk. I have to go down to the stream, take a picture of the ice. So how did your curry turn out, Uma?
Shooting as they went.
Little children running upstairs, isn't that nice?
said. Don't shoot. Birdie and I have already caught the wolf. Now help us take him to the zoo.
You think you should try my recipe? It's not my recipe. It's just the one I tried, but it sure worked out. Everybody liked it. Jean, who is a chef, he really liked it. And it was good because it wasn't just like hit and miss. Well, let's try to see what happens with this. Somebody else already figured it out. I thought Thai food was really hot, but it's not if you don't put a lot of hot in it. And they use those same... Wish my cat was inside right now. He's been gone for 2 days and hasn't come back. I'm sorry. Where do you think he is?
After him, the hunters leading the wolf.
So we're going to have some Christmas music, but I have to download some Christmas albums that are good albums. Like, it's all within your $9 a month. Unlimited music of every kind. And you can go on the radio and tell it to open a certain station. And it will, and you can listen to the news, you can listen to the radio. Can you see what I'm doing? No, you can't see what I'm doing, or you can't see my face. And when I turn it this way, you still can't see what I'm doing. I had a better place to put you.
And winding up the procession,
my daughter's got a really good way of doing her live videos.
Discontentedly. Where and if Peter hadn't caught the wolf, what then?
Yeah, coyotes. So where are you, Kiara? Not in Holland, that was Kristen. What part of Holland are you in? Did you watch my Holland videos, Kristen? Are you still here? People come and people go. And people go and people come. I unplug my mother's Google thing when I go to her house. It feels like a recording device. Oh. I understand that. You know, I was thinking about all of our, the way they, do great big data gathering with your phones. They can see when that phone is in front of a certain part of the grocery store when an item is looked at, and then when the item is bought. And so they can get an idea of all the places that you looked and the kind of things that you were interested in and the things you weren't interested in. And, you know, we think, oh, this is just the beginning of gathering of this data. But do you know what kind of studies are going to be done with data like this in 100 years? If we're still around in 100 years. Depends on what this global weather, and most important, on what the Lord thinks. People are not really being that great. So there's all these things that were prophesied are happening. Some people are pretty great. If you're not good, you'll lose the land of your inheritance. And it happens. Thank you. then the land will be given to someone else. That's the way the Lord works. I think I'm doing this so you can see it. I mean, if I was going to do it so I could see it, I would do it like this. And I wouldn't care about whether you can see it or not. And since you can't really see it anyway, I might as well do it this anyway. A lot easier. Just look straight at it. We should listen to Christmas music now, don't you think? Morning prayer. Okay, Jennifer, just a minute. We're going to have morning prayer. Listening to Peter and the Wolf. Hello? I just turned off the music. It was Peter and the Wolf. It was on pretty loudly.
Oh, yes, I thought it was coming from
that. I ordered Google Play Music.
Oh, yes.
So if you were going to play music, what would you have it play?
I was going to play music.
Oh, okay, Google, play Led Zeppelin.
Okay, Google.
Awesome. Oh, I have to turn her up.
Are you cleaning stuff in the dishwasher?
I think Dad cleaned I think he ran the top one. Dumbed. Hey, it's not playing. Okay, Google, play.
Playing Led Zeppelin on Google Play Music.
Turn up the volume.
You have to say, okay, Google, turn up the volume by 20%. Okay, Google, play. Did you get any sleep last night? Were the children sleeping?
Yeah, it was all right.
Good. Okay, Google.
Maybe it just starts really quiet.
Oh.
But I don't hear anything. This is just
okay, Google. Increase volume.
Right, I'm going
upstairs. So now suddenly it'll just start working. You'll have Led Zeppelin blaring in the kitchen. Okay. We have 9 people. So what's going on over there? Okay, what am I listening to? I was listening to Christmas music. And then I was listening to Peter and the Wolf. Aw, Uma. Okay, Google. Uma likes you. Okay, Guma.
Sorry, I don't understand.
I know. It was unkind that she said she didn't, but we're just going to forgive, okay? Okay, Google. Play. Ha, ha, ha. Play. I really like O Holy Night. Silent Night. Okay, Google, play Silent Night at 50% music. Volume.
Playing Silent Night piano solo instrumental on YouTube Music.
I'm running out of battery again. See all that nature in there? See, if you pull it, it falls out. Well, sometimes it doesn't. Say a prayer yet. Let's say our prayers. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you so much for this new day. It's really cold outside. It's negative 17 and it's too cold to go out. And please bless me that I'll be able to get this thing done and be warm. And take pictures of the stream and the ice, my daily ice photos. And thank you so much for helping my back get better. My pain is going away. I'm so grateful. And please bless everybody out there with pain that they will be able to find out how to make their pain go away too. Please bless them. Bless everybody. Help everybody get through the trials that they're going through. So many people are in so many trials. Some are humongous, and some are just humongous to us, but not to other people. We'd like to ask that Thou will be with us while we go through these things. Keep us safe and prompt us. Help us to hear Thy voice, still small voice, and help us to tune in so that we can be guided by it. And avoid troubles and difficulty and have lots of joy and happiness in our life. Help us to navigate through this life. And this we pray in Jesus Christ's name. Amen. There you go. That was our morning prayer. Thank you for asking me to say morning prayer. I couldn't really do that on my own because people might think, oh, she's here preaching to us. I wouldn't want to preach to people. But I like it when Heavenly Father's with me because then everything goes a lot better. So easy to forget him. My goodness, it's so easy. Life gets right in the way really quick. Say a prayer 10 minutes later, forgot. It's really amazing. Okay, what's your song? What would you like Google to play? Welcome, Aura. Ainsley. Ainsley is a girl's name. No, is that their last name? Ainsley. I think it's her first name. Ainsley.
And so it continued both.
So this is our Christmas caroling. Let's do Christmas caroling together. I'll stick these live videos. I'll stick them in front of Willem and he can play Christmas. Yes. So when I go for my walk, you can't come. Sorry, no live connection. Unless I go way up on the hill. There's a really high hill, and if I go up on it, then there's internet. But you can't do a live video over data, I don't think. I think it'll lose up a lot of data, and I'll be out of time again this month. Fun. That was because I uploaded my videos as we drove. Drove to Toronto. Okay, what did you ask? You really enjoy Willem playing? Yeah, it's nice. He, so often now, he doesn't play because there's so many times that children are sleeping. There's the morning naps with quiet time, and then there's early bedtimes, and, you know. So Willem doesn't play as much as he used to play. He edits his compositions. He's written a whole bunch of beautiful music. He's not shared it yet. How old will he be when he shares it? It's 6069. He needs to put it all out there. You know, the idea is to put it out there, make money, or, you know, have copyright on it. And I don't think that's going to be very important. I mean, it might be great if you had money coming in from something like that, but it's just going to slow you down from being able to share it. About Google Play is that it just keeps playing whatever music it feels like playing after you ask it the first song. It gets a little distracted and does its own thing. Remind you of anything? Anyone? 112 minutes we've been here. Well, we're all here anyway, so we might as well be together, right? So what's your plans today, Uma? Oh, I wanted to know, how did your stuff turn out yesterday? You made, what did you make? Yellow curry. And you used the paste. So what did you put in your yellow curry? Yesterday, I did lentils. And so the curry was, so I cooked my lentils in coconut milk. But the coconut milk that you buy here is not, it's got xanthan gum, guar gum and xanthan or something. And it doesn't taste like, doesn't have the flavor of coconut. Like, if you take a coconut, this is how you do it. I should make a video on that. You take a real coconut and you chop off the end. You break it open with a hack. You hold it like that and you whack it really hard with your machete. Just saying. And then you take a little paring knife and you go down in and you get the coconut out. Then you grate the coconut, then you put the coconut in water and then you cook it. And then you take out the coconut itself, you milk it, squeeze all the coconut and you strain the coconut out, because that's not very good to eat, I hear. And but it's great for washing your hands. You can take all that ground coconut stuff and rub your hands. Mung beans and rice with veggies, curry powder. I'm tired of eating it, though, even though it's yummy. But after a a week, it's boring. I have the solution to your problem. You need room in the freezer, and you need pint jars, or half pint jars. Yeah, half pint jars. Or those pint. No, pint is... is that big, so you'd use a half pints. Willem, is that you?
Nope.
Hello, Mr. Daddy-O.
Hello.
Sorry it was so loud and chaotic here last time.
That's okay.
Before you'd even had your coffee. I guess nobody's getting to sleep in today, eh?
Well, 8:30 is time for sleeping in. Sleeping in for me.
You're right. Oh, Jean.
Yes?
Can I ask for a favor?
Mm-hmm.
Our snowblower has something bent on it, so I can't use the snowblower without a lot of noise.
Oh.
So I have to take it to the place, but I have to get the trailer out.
Right.
So Willem is emptying the leaves out of the trailer. There's stuff in there, but right. It would be nice if you could drive your truck in there. If you could back up to
yeah,
it.
I could try and do that.
It's in front of Grandma's cottage.
Right.
And I think it's free now. And it shouldn't be too heavy.
Yeah, I'll try and do that.
Okay.
Sure.
Thanks. Well, let me know when you feel like it. You don't have to...
Yeah, probably in a little bit.
Okay. Thank you. See, there are great perks to having kids living at home. Something's wrong with Maya. She's not happy. Why would she not be happy? Life is so good. La, 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 la. In excelsis Deo gloria. So Jean is going to help us. Willem? John's gonna help us. Well,
where are you?
In here. Where Jean is gonna help us get the trailer out.
Okay.
Hi. Sometime, you know, in a little while, he said. So.
Okay.
But he's not right now. Right.
Okay.
But when he's ready. So we can get the trailer out, and then we can hook it on the other car, and then I can take the snowblower out and get it fixed.
Okay.
Before it snows again. It's a good thing we haven't had snow for a while. We would be truly snowed in. Gotta get that trailer out, because it's kind of snowed.
Okay, I better get turkey. Maybe I should go to the dump?
No, you should go down and empty the leaves out.
Okay, all right then. First, I have to get some leaves.
But you might... I mean, the leaves aren't going to really matter. Now, is it... Have you... He can't hear me. La, la, la. La, la. Excelsis Deo. Gloria. In excelsis Deo. See him whose birth the angels adore on bended knee. Him she play. Margarine container, just you. It's only one in the fridge. It's a big one, right? Oh, I don't know anything about that. I want to save that song. I like it. The name of that piece, Willem?
Pickleball.
What?
Pickleball.
I'm sorry?
Yeah.
My earring is not very good either.
No, I haven't watched the mouth. No, I haven't watched the mouth.
It was Pickleball's Cannon.
Oh, Pickleball's Cannon, that's right. Righteousness, hail to home. In his wings, while he lays his glory by, born that man may die, born to bring the sons of earth, born to bring them second birth. the herald angels sing. To me, this is the perfect Christmas, is sitting around listening to Christmas music. Born Prince of Peace. I've been reading in the Book of Mormon, and I'm at the part where Samuel the Lamanite is telling them about the coming of Christ. There'll be a light of day and no dark moon. Oh no, is it laundry day again?
Oh, bedding.
Oh, all the throwed up people. Oh, I know.
I have to wash our bedding.
And they're bedding, I guess.
Did you clean all the leaves out of the thing yet?
No, no, no.
Oh, so you want to do that later? Because I gotta go today.
Oh, Willem, you can leave the leaves in it. Willem?
The leaves are very heavy.
Something like go to a coffee shop and make a live video, just hang out there or at Tim Hortons or you know whatever where people go where there's internet. Of course now the grocery store is internet.
Read to the newborn king, hark the herald angels sing, glory to the newborn king.
Oh, Uma, so I was going to tell you what you can do with your food that's left over. You got too much food. Uma, so I was going to tell you what you can do with your food that's left over. You got too much food. Instead of trying to eat the whole thing until you're sick of it, just put most of it in jars, pint size, so that's a cup in each one. And then when you're hungry, you can just take one with you. Put it in the microwave or whatever, thaw it out.
Give you my heart, merry next day, you gave it away. It's Christmas, give it to someone special. It's Christmas, special. It's Christmas, give you my heart, very next day, you gave it away.
Hey, you know, my gypsy cabin, I can't video from down there, not live anyway, but I closed all my windows, I got everything sealed up in there so I could, and I need to take down I have some Coleman heaters, I'm going to try and heat that up in there so I can sit there and be warm and read my scriptures and whatever it is I do down there. I have all my books and my birds and my grasses. I need a book on all the kinds of snow. People that don't live with snow think snow is one kind. It falls and you make the snowman. Not true.
Give you my heart, very next day, give it away.
This was from the late 70s, I think. When I lived in Phoenix, I think I listened to this on the radio.
Very next day, gave it away.
See how it's coming along? That's my thumb. I could make earmuffs. Willem? What about seeing if Jean can pull it out with the leaves in it, and then we just roll the snowblower up on. How heavy is way too heavy? I mean, leaves are light, and they've been rained on. Well, I guess they were damp when I got them. Well, that's what I mean. So why not just... Oh, I know what you can do. Open the back of the trailer, get inside, and push them all out. Well, you can push them off of the road. You don't have to leave them right there on the middle of the road. They are on the side anyway. That would be easier than lifting them. They're so heavy. Some young fellow stopped and helped me do it. Snow. After they spray, it takes 2 days for that weird snow or whatever weird weather they program. Let's see. Are you looking at the designs to try and make it the same way? Hey, you know what you could use? You could use Play-Doh to stick them together. You could make those balls out of Play-Doh, and then you could stick the two into the sides of it. It wouldn't be strong. It wouldn't. You couldn't pick it up or anything. But so I could guess I could come down and help you with that. Except Desmond's here now, and I think I should be with Desmond.
No, it's okay. I can do it here. No worries.
Tell me, come. And if you get cold, go in the winter. Go in the
gypsy cabin.
Gypsy cabin. But you know, remember the stove and the jar, the three propane tanks you brought up. Can you take them back down? And leave them in the gypsy cabin. They don't go up here. That's for me warming up when I'm down there. I'll come down there when we can warm up in the gypsy cabin.
So where are they?
In the woodshed.
My arm's in armor.
Whoa. Let's see your armor. It does look like armor.
Yeah.
Like a shield.
But it's supposed to be on my body.
Oh, yeah. That'll protect you. It'll protect you from flying leaves. Falling leaves. They won't be able to hit you.
Yeah, I need more armor.
More armor. Ha, hey, who put them all back? Did you put them all back?
No.
They're all put back. Just take out the one you're going to use. And then take out one more. Okay, that would be best.
No, I'm taking the ones I need.
Just the ones you need. Perfect. Oh, it maybe goes right over your shoulder. May peaceful wings unfurl with angels winging to the earth to hear the foretold on the earth goodwill to men and hams all gracious King. The world in silence stillness lay, and now the angels sing. Here's my mitten. Did you want to try it on? Can you put it on your hand just so I can take a picture of it?
Oh, my goodness.
Oh, look at your armor on your legs. There it is. Let me get a photo of that now. How do I do a photo of it?
Angels.
Did it take a picture?
What? You took a selfie.
Oh, that's me? Oh, there. Oh, dear. Okay. Oh, orientation is locked. There. Thank you. Can you put it down lower? No, not like that lower. Just stand up and just turn it that way. There we go. Oh, that was not it. That was muting it. Which now the angel sing. There. Okay, I got it. Took a long time. Thank you, Willem. It's getting warmer on the edges now. It's warm on the back and it's warm on the sides. Walking in the winter wonderland. Oh, hi, Rosie. Oh, how nice to talk to you. Oh, you know, I was thinking about snow, how snow is on the... They have this spray stuff. They used to have it when I was little. It was this sort of a... kind of a gooey thing that would stick to itself, and you would spray it on the side of your windows to make it look like snow. Well, I can do that. We'll just blow the snowblower at the windows. Break the windows. We could throw snow, and it would pile into the corners like that. After you have a good blizzard or something, you have that. I'm happy tonight, happy tonight, walking in the winter wonderland. There's a snowman, and Parson Brown, he can marry no man, but you can do the job when you're in town. Conspire as we sit by the fire. Happy tonight. Da, da, da. So what are you going to do today? And when will you be back? You're going out? And where are you going? Do you have errands to run? Are you doing Christmas shopping? Is that too early? Is it raining? Snowing? Blizzarding? Hey, there's supposed to be bad weather going somewhere. Asheville Moving Company said. Are you still there, Asheville, or are you gone? People come and people go so quickly around here. I just see a number 8. Hey, 7 thumbs up. Thank you, guys. There's never more thumbs up than people, even though people come and go. It's interesting to watch the thumbs up phenomenon. It's a real act of service to do a thumbs up for somebody. This is the nice one. I didn't think that's what it was. I thought it was sleigh bells. All of the other you still don't even call him names. Never let poor Rudolph join in any reindeer games. Then one foggy Christmas Eve, Santa came to sleigh. Off with their nose so bright. I've been watching Santa movies. The reindeer loved him as he sat. Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer, you'll go down his story. Then one foggy Christmas Eve, Santa came to say, Rudolph with their nose so bright, won't you guide my sleigh tonight? Then how the reindeer loved him,
okay,
as they shouted out with glee. nose reindeer. Never learn his story. We should gather around the piano and have Christmas caroling one day. It would be nice. We could all sing together. I hear a little child. I hear a little Maya. My drum. Rum pa pum. Thank you.